Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the candidate city of Lausanne, Switzerland, which is bidding to host the Winter Youth Olympic Games 2020.
Dear friends and colleagues, please offer a very warm welcome to the delegation of Lausanne. This delegation is led by the Minister of Defence and Sport of Switzerland, Mr. Uli Maurer, the President of Swiss Olympic, Mr. Jörg Schild, and the Mayor of the City of Lausanne, Mr. Daniel Prelat. Ladies and gentlemen, dear delegation from Lausanne, the floor is yours.
Mr. President, dear members and friends, it is a great honor for me to stand today in front of you and to tell you about a bit from my own country, from a city in which I lived one of the best parts of my life and which started my career in sport. It is an honor, but also a challenge. It is a challenge because you all know this city very well, Lausanne. So today, we'd like to do things a little different. We want to tell you about a Lausanne you may know less, about the Lausanne that could hopefully offer even more to the youth of the world and the Olympic movement. But first, let me introduce you to our team. Some of them will address you directly. Some will be here available for your questions later. As introduced, the Mayor of Lausanne, Monsieur Daniel Prelat, the Minister of Economy and Sport of the Canton de Vaud, Monsieur Philippe Lebas, and Mr. Gian Gilli, former chef de mission at Swiss Olympic and head of all the technical aspects of our bid. But the other members are here too in the room, including my three wiser uncles and members of the IOC. You know, I also know Lausanne a little bit. After spending my childhood in Italy, my mother decided it was time to come back home, Switzerland. I wasn't pleased at all. So she said, come back and you can choose where you want to go and study. So I traveled Switzerland and I chose Lausanne for the quality of its university, but also for the wonderful location by the lake facing the Alps and only 3 hours from some very amazing European cities. But I chose Lausanne because I knew I could do what I wanted, study, of course, but also be in the world of basketball 7 days a week. That is the Lausanne that I know. It's a place where young people can study at the highest level and still practice a lot of sports at all levels every single day. It was already the case for me 30 years ago. Now, today, with 55 international federations based there and in the region, like my own, FIBA, and with more than 2,000 people working in international sports, there are even more opportunities. Let's give this to the young people in 2020. Let's give them access to the best sports experts using the best practices and the newest technologies, whether it is for infrastructure, for the sport material, or for digital communication. Let's make the Youth Games shine right from the Olympic capital. I finished my study, or I was just about to finish my studies in law, and I thought I needed a job. So I went and I knocked at the door of the IOC. Didn't work out that well. I was not that unhappy. I finished my study and soon after I started in FIBA. And in my wildest dreams, I would not have thought that 21 years later, I would stand here in front of you, in all of you, promoting this very city, my mountains, our youth. And I'm standing here today in front of you because Lausanne was my start. That's why I would be honored to give back to this city. Something more than what you know, airport, hotels, meetings, offices. A whole city turned into a huge field of play, right in the middle of the international sports world. But this is not my only dream. It's not only mine. It is a national dream and an ambition. And for that, I would like to tell you more, the Switzerland's Minister of Sport, Mr. Ueli Maurer.
Mr. President, members of the IOC, ladies and gentlemen, in the name of the Swiss government, I have the great pleasure to confirm not only our total support and commitment for this project, but also our guarantee to deliver a risk-free event in full respect with the Olympic Charter and IOC regulations. But beyond that, I want to tell you why we, as a nation, would like to host these games. In 1915, Switzerland said welcome to an idea brought to us by Pierre de Coubertin. We said welcome to his vision to bridge people and cultures through sport. Imagine welcome, youth of the world in that same place, to provide them with a strong message, the message of Olympism. You know, Switzerland had a tradition for being the ambassadors of peace, for being mediators between nations. We could be a great place to create the next ambassadors of Olympism worldwide. In December last year, in Monaco, my colleague Didier Burkhalter, then president of our country, stood in front of you, reaffirming the importance of your movement, not only for our country, but around the world. He talked about its importance in encouraging the practice of sport, in creating dreams and aspirations. So I can guarantee you that if the flame came to our country in 2020, we would treat it with the respect and the importance it deserves. In 1915, we said welcome to the Olympic movement. Today, 100 years later, we ask you for your permission to say welcome to the youth of the world.
At the heart of Europe lies a small, perfectly formed country where everything works like clockwork. From Geneva Airport, it is an easy 45-minute drive to the city of Lausanne.
For 100 years, Lausanne has been the home of Olympism.
In the future, it will be the home of our Youth Olympic Game memories.
And those memories will be made by the best of Swiss precision and organization. The efficient shuttle connects all of the venues to the futuristic York Village, which will be home to students long into the future.
La jeunesse est notre avenir.
In the new Lausanne Olympic Village, we will be the future.
Education and culture shape vocations.
Our vocation is to create a better future through sport.
Even Lausanne's famous Espace Malais will have a better future. Figure skating, hockey and short track will be hosted at this updated arena. And the opening and closing ceremonies will be held on the banks of beautiful Lac Léman at the Stade Pierre de Coubertin. Skiers and boarders will compete in the nearby mountains of Lesins, Les Diablerets and Villars. Every year, throughout the winter season, dozens of competitions are staged here. Switzerland has always been at the forefront of alpine skiing, This capability, built up over generations, will give every athlete the chance to learn about the administration and organization of events. And that doesn't stop at competition venues. Athletes, spectators, and the Olympic family will have the chance to experience the best of Swiss hospitality and entertainment in the city of Lausanne, the heart of the Youth Olympic Games. Competitors in the Nordic skiing events will spend their days in the nearby Jura region, which welcomes more than 10,000 spectators to its World Cup event each year.
Swiss expertise will give the athletes the best chance to perform at their best in the best venues.
In 2020, with this expertise around us, we can find our own success.
Le Centre du Sport International est le lieu idéal pour fêter l'Olympisme avec le monde.
We too, we want to influence the world.
Depuis plus de 100 ans, les gens viennent en Suisse parce que ceci est capable de créer et d'innover.
In Lausanne, we will create our future.
Maybe it's because we are a small country. We've always nurtured future generations. That's why we want to have the chance to host the Youth Olympic Games in Lausanne in 2020.
We can do this in Lausanne.
We can do it in Lausanne.
À Lausanne, nous construirons notre futur.
This is where it starts.
Dear Mr. President, dear friends, allow me to speak today in French.
The Youth Olympic Games are only just beginning, and they are still growing. That it's normal, therefore, that you should be discussing the role that they should play within our movement. So let me share with you today the vision of our National Olympic Committee. One of our roles is to disseminate the positive values of sport in our country. So when we had the opportunity to be a candidate for the games that put these values at the forefront, even a country like ours that sometimes does say no must say yes. So we said yes to the Youth Olympic Games because they can be a fantastic way to bring our youth closer to these values. We have said yes to the games because they can help us give more visibility to our associations, to be more present in our schools. And we also said yes because these games can act as a catalyst to motivate and inspire our youth. Lausanne is a city of sport, of education, of innovation. The games in Lausanne will be about that: learning, sharing, innovating. We take these games seriously because we take our youth seriously. But to speak about youth, let's leave room for younger ones, and I have the honor of introducing to you two of our most talented sports people: Virginie Fèvre, triple world champion in freestyle ski and responsible for our culture and education program, and Stéphane Lambiel, double world champion in figure skating, silver medalist in Turin, and athlete ambassador for the 2012 Games in Innsbruck.
Bonjour tout le monde.
Hi everybody.
Stéphane and I have been part of this adventure from the very beginning, about 2 years ago. It's been a fantastic journey. It's been a lot of work, but most of all, lots of fun.
You know, we might be a small country, but we are a big winter sports nation. Virginie and I are children of Swiss sport. We did not need to go somewhere else to practice for the sport we love. We did not need to go somewhere else to trained to win medals. We did everything from home.
But it was not easy. We are some of the lucky ones. The line between success and failure is very thin. This is one of the reasons why we wanted to be involved.
Because this is what's great about youth games. They not only tell the youth that they can be great athletes, they also tell them that they can be great sports leaders, doctors, nutritionists, coaches.
Lausanne is the right place to do this for three reasons: a unique Olympic heritage, the expertise of international sports world, and the capacity to envision the future with world-class universities. These three things combined can build a great new generation of sports leaders.
You know, I was just 12 years old when I first saw the figure skating world championship in Lausanne in 1997. That day, I got inspired. I decided I want to do this for the rest of my life. Since then, our region has hosted more than 30 international events. So I won't tell you about our winter sport experience. I'll just ask you to imagine. Imagine figure skating, hockey, short track, speed skating, all of them in a brand new venue just around the corner from the village.
Imagine freestyle skiing in a place known around the world for its fantastic snow park. Imagine alpine skiing in the Alps next to a 3,000 meter glacier.
Imagine cross-country skiing in a place with a history of more than 100 years in the sport. Imagine ski jumping and biathlon just next door in France in a great venue.
A sustainable idea right in line with the IOC Agenda 2020.
Imagine the opening ceremony in the Pierre de Coubertin Stadium by the lake. Imagine athletes walking.
Walking?
Yes, walking from the village on their way to the stadium, passing right in front of the brand new IOC headquarters.
Imagine all athletes not only in one village, but under one single roof. Imagine a cultural program inside the village, in the heart of the Swiss Silicon Valley. Imagine the athlete taking the subway right in front of the village to go directly downtown in 10 minutes for the medal ceremonies and the party with the local population. Imagine the games in Lausanne.
I can. And I'm not the only one. A lot of other athletes imagine that too. Some of them not even from winter sports.
Oh, yes?
Yes. Some of them are even tennis players.
Come on, what do you mean?
Okay, let me give you a hint. Tennis, two Swiss guys, together 19 Grand Slam titles, one Davis Cup, and three Olympic medals.
I think I know.
Okay, let's take a look.
Growing up in Lausanne, I know how enthusiastic people are about sports here. It will be great to welcome the Youth Olympic Games 2020 in the region. I'm a big fan of Olympic Games and I would love to see young Olympic athletes compete in my hometown. Hope to see you all in Lausanne. A bientôt. Merci.
Hello, everyone. I'm a big fan of the Olympic Games, as you know, since 2000. I've been competing in them myself. And I would have loved to compete in a youth game, not in probably in a winter youth Olympic Games like what we're trying to bid for here in Lausanne. It's a beautiful city, actually. I've lived in it for two years when I was between 14 and 16. They love their sports there, and for that reason, I really support this bid. And hopefully, I'll see you in Lausanne in 2020. All the very best. See you.
How about that?
Well, they're great. Well, I'm sure I could teach them a thing or two on skis.
Come on, Virginie, don't be like that. Be serious.
Okay. Mesdames et messieurs, heritage, expertise, innovation. Lausanne is a great match for the Youth Games.
Lausanne is the place that can start a career.
Lausanne, this is where it starts.
Thank you.
Mr. President, chers collègues, queridos amigos, this is where it started for me. This is where it started for them. And this is where it could start for all of them and many more. We would like to have these games. No, in fact, we want them. We can deliver. The Olympic capital would be a fantastic host for the youth of the world and the Olympic movement. Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. President, thank you for your attention. We are ready for your questions.
Thank you very much to the delegation of Lausanne for an excellent presentation. And now I would like to open the floor for any questions from IOC members, International Winter Sports Federations, and National Olympic Committees. And for this, I hand over to the Director General, Mr. De Keppa, please.
Thank you, President. If you have any questions, please raise your hands. I have one from Mr. Guy Dru. Any other questions?
No, Mr. Dru, please.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you very much, President. I just wanted to congratulate and thank the two cities for their presentations. And I just wanted to point out that we won't be able to participate in the vote, we the French, because a part of the events will take place on French territory. But I did want to thank and congratulate the president of the Swiss Olympic Committee for having spoken in French. Thank you.
I will not ask you to answer this question. Since there are obviously no other questions, I say thank you very much to the delegation of Lausanne. There is a belated question coming in. So
yes,
back to square.
Mr. Cinquanta.
Well, thank you very much indeed for your presentation, as well as the one of Lord Blasov. And to the Swiss delegation, I would like to say the following. It is not very easy, because this is not a technical part, but is a dedication part. I have personally the impression that Switzerland is giving not enough in the area of sport, in summer sport and in winter sport. Maybe it's your character. Maybe you would like to deliver what you can. But I do believe personally that you could offer more. So if I remember Stefan Lambiel, Favre, Zurbriggen, and so on, I think I've been seeing Wawrinka and Federer, I think that you can do much more than that. The fact that you are hosting the International Olympic Committee is another story. The fact that you are hosting many international sport federations is another fact, you know? But what we need is to have more dedication from Switzerland. And I do believe personally that this is a personal point of view, that you could offer more to the world of sport.
Mr. Cinquanta, I'm very sorry. Could you ask a question?
Why they do not offer more to the world of sport?
Thank you very much for your question. And now I hand over to the delegation of Lausanne. I'm happy that I do not have to answer.
Caro Presidente, grazie.
Thank you, President. Thank you very much for that question.
I believe that our federal councillor and minister of sport certainly can offer you a part of the answer, and as well as our minister of state of the Canton de Vaud, who I believe is hosting many of our colleagues and of our friends in the international sport, may have some other parts to say.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we have a lot of international events in Switzerland. I think we do a lot of sport, forced sport, and I think this Youth Olympic Game is a first step to do more. You know, we have a system with a lot of votation in common in Canton on the basis of the federation, and we have still need a majority of this population for big events. And I think that's important for us, that we can do this first step with this Youth Olympic Game. And I hope that I can present you one candidacy for more. But with our people, we are ready now for do this.
Monsieur le Président, encore Monsieur Lebas pour ajouter deux mots.
Perhaps Mr. Lebas could add something. President, ladies and gentlemen, members of the IOC, of course we listen to this question, and the fact that we are a candidate and we want to organize the 2020 Youth Games, it is precisely to be able to offer more to the Olympic movement.
Mr. President, I believe this concludes the session on the questions.
So before I try again to thank the delegation, I ask whether there is one more question. I can't see any. So now I hope finally thank you very much to the delegation of Lausanne, also for your answer to the question. You can be very proud. With your candidature, you have inspired your population and many young sports fans. Thank you for promoting the Olympic values in such an excellent way. Thank you for embracing Olympic Agenda 2020. On behalf of the International Olympic Committee, I would like to present you with the diploma to commemorate your excellent contribution to the promotion of Olympic values. May I invite Minister Uli Maurer to join me and accept this diploma.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the candidate city presentation for Lausanne. Thank you and congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes indeed the presentations by the candidate cities for the Winter Youth Olympic Games 2020. We shall now take a short break and resume at 10:30 a.m. for the presentations of the candidate cities for the Olympic Winter Games 2022. I would kindly ask you to be seated 10 minutes in advance for the presentation of Almaty, Kazakhstan, and Beijing, China. Thank you.